Still on electoral matters, the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, has received reviews for its conduct of the just concluded Edo State governorship election. The election, which saw the candidate of the PDP, Governor Godwin Obaseki, and that of the APC, Osagie Ezeyamo, lock horns in a tightly contested governorship election. Our correspondent, Amadine Uyi, tells us more.
It was a tense electoral process. After hours of results collation, which spanned almost 2 days, the winner finally emerged.
Osiage Ezeyamu of APC had 223,619 votes. Godwin N. Obaseki of the PDP had 307,955. That Godwin N. Obaseki of PDP, having satisfied the requirement of the law in meeting the 25% in two-thirds of the local government area in the state, and having a margin of lead higher than the council vote, is hereby declared the winner and returned elected. Signed by the minister.
Representatives of the two major political parties, the All Progressives Congress APC and the People's Democratic Party PDP, however, expressed mixed reactions.
Feels good. The people came out, they voted, and they voted their choice. And the most exciting part of it was that they voted, and instantly their votes counted, because INEC promised to upload the result. And they did. That gave a huge credibility to this process. And I think that that can also drive, you know, voters coming out in future elections. So it's a way to reduce voter apathy. It's a way to give complete credibility to the voting process. And I must commend INEC as an institution.
If you have been in this hall since morning, you could see the drama that has been acting here. And if I have to make specific reference to what you saw for Orion on local government, and incidentally, that is the local government of our candidate, Pastor Osagie Ezeyamu. You could see that even the man that prepared the result couldn't even read what he was preparing. And for having stayed even 5 hours waiting for him, and he's still fidgeting, shows you the kind of malpractice that has been done in the local government.
One election observer group present singled out INEC and Edo State residents for the success of the process.
One of the major interests that I had that I showcased to me is the level of commitment of the Edo people. Despite the fact that people have been chanting that there's going to be violence and people who may be killed and all, they still come out and vote for the candidate of their choice. Then secondly, INEC did something that is very, very different. One, with regard to the Z-pad that they introduced, the Z-pad at least...
It was an
issue of collation center. That collation center have been categorized to be where rigging take place. So people now are getting confidence that what they vote is what is being announced. And that way it will increase the level of voter to come out.
The result brings an end to months of hard work by political players involved in the elections. Observers will admit that it was a keen contest between the main candidates of the two major parties. Residents of Edo State will be hoping that now that the election is over, the business of governance will continue. Amadine Uyi, Plus TV Africa.
Thank you, Amadine Uyi, for following all the events there for us. And joining us live now to have a conversation around this election is Joe Igbokwe, who is APC chieftain and former publicity secretary, Lagos APC. Also joining us live is Segun Showumi, who is the PDP chieftain and former spokesman to Abubakar Atiku. Good to have you, gentlemen. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm well. We would begin with Mr. Igbokwe, who is joining us via phone. Good to have you, Mr. Igbokwe.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
All right. Very quickly, what's your reaction to the Edo governorship election result?
The people have spoken, and we have no choice than to accept what the results. You know, I only want to thank God, because APC is not PDP. You get me?
I'm listening.
I said APC is not PDP.
And what do you mean
and
by that?
I also thank God that PMB, the President Buhari, is not Obasanjo of PDP. So you could see what took place. And we have accepted it. We have moved on. 300 and something thousand votes is not a joke. 200 and something thousand votes is not a joke. So we have moved on. But this is a lesson. Don't forget what happened in Nigeria in 2003 when Obasanjo of PDP stole all the states in the Southwest except Lagos. We live with it. But today you are seeing a different ball game. You are seeing decency. You are seeing preparations. We are seeing neutrality in matters of electoral process. That is the lesson that we must take home.
Right.
Okay?
Okay. While we still have you there, let's go to Mr. Showumi to hear his thoughts as well on this election result. Mr. Showumi.
Well, first of all, I would have to say congratulations to ourselves, the PDP, and our candidate, Godwin Obaseki, who has been declared the winner by the people of Edo and obviously the electoral umpires. As to what one can call his immediate reaction, I would want to say that as we proceed, the democratic process is getting more matured and the people are beginning to be more resolute. In terms of who's to be patted on the back and who's to be blamed, if there be any, I'll say that the people rejected the interloping meddlesomeness of the characters in Lagos and some other funny people who want to insist that it's their way or the highway. I heard my friend Joe say, oh, Obasanjo did this, Obasanjo did that. We left that ship, we left that Egypt a long time ago. What Nigerians were nervous about in going to Edo was the misbehavior and the misdemeanor of Kogi, where before our eyes, everything became like a mess. And that they met their match and their Waterloo in Edo, where the people of Benin over the years have shown that they are very culturally stable people, they're very resolute people, and they're very determined people once their mind is made up. And obviously, there was absolutely no room for them to misbehave, and there were going to be likely consequences. And I saw they put their tail between their legs and waddled out of Edo quickly. I think that that's what I'll say about that. In terms of the two contestants, they put in the best they could. Elections are very difficult to push together. Before you agree, arrange yourself, put your manifesto, you push as hard as you can. But once that is done, the next thing that needs to happen now is for you to wait for the verdict of the people. And if everybody believes that INEC is now beginning to do what we want it to do, unlike what happened in the 2019 presidential election, where they suddenly could not transmit results from the polling unit, we're seeing that that is happening now. The hue and cry of Nigerians have worked in that regard. Therefore, we will say election credibility should not be a flash in the pan or things we guess about. It should become the norm and not the exception. Edo has turned out well. People are happy about it. The security operators and the managers of our architecture of security have handled themselves very well. They've stabilized the environment. They've ensured that the whole thing did not go up in flames. And of course, we are happy. Political parties will lose some elections. And sure, political parties will win some elections. Mm-hmm. So as far as I'm concerned, we'll say democracy is beginning to mature in the country. YIGA Africa has endorsed it. We are saying it's good. It can be improved. The turnout is relative to the numbers that is available. You have a voter architecture of about 2 million and only about 500,000 people are almost like a quarter of it or thereabout participated. It therefore shows that the more you have elections that the people's votes can count, democracy and participatory in elections become the better for it. So I think that so far so good. Let us hope that now that the governor has won the second time, he's going to commit himself to carrying more people along, to making Edo light understand that under heaven, there's only one Edo state. And obviously, I greet them with the traditional way of greeting themselves, Oba Atope.
Mm-hmm, yes, sir. All right, let's get Mr. Egbukwe's thoughts also on other matters. I mean, Mr. Egbukwe, you mentioned there that you have moved on. Your party, you've moved on. You've seen the result. You accept the result. But what are the lessons for your party particularly? Because some believe the party self-destructs itself. Or do you think otherwise?
No. You see, when PDP wins,
democracy is not under threat. Everything is normal. But when APC wins, democracy is under threat. Rigging everywhere. We have to accept this. Because more elections are coming. We have accepted it and we have moved on. We expect that in the future elections, when we win, they will not say democracy is in danger or democracy is under threat. That is the lessons. And we are taking it. Because if you go to hunting expedition, sometimes you can get some animals. Sometimes you will not get. That is the spirit of sportsmanship. You go home. We are going home. But elections are still coming. We saw what happened in Rivers State. Democracy is working. We saw what happened in Bayelsa. Democracy is working. We saw how it happened in Delta State. Democracy is working. When APC wins, then democracy is in danger. This is the lesson. Elections are coming. Right. We expect that when we defeat them, they would accept it the way we have accepted it and move on.
All right. Okay? We will be on the lookout and see how things pan out. I mean, it's an interesting analogy you used there, talking about going for the hunting expedition. Sometimes you get something, yes. Some other time you don't, and you go home.
Yes.
So sticking on that, let's still speak to Mr. Shawumi on the other end. Do you think this is truly a victory for PDP? Because for some, PDP was just an opportunist. What do you say?
First of all, when Joe says it's like a hunting expedition, it speaks to the mindset of the APC, who sees Nigerians as animals to be hunted with guns. We see it differently.
I think he's just using
what
an analogy.
What we demand and what we say is that every time there is an election, if it is a standalone election, each election is going to be discussed within the merit of what everybody sees in that election. There is no magic to democracy. If the people reject you at the polls, you go home. But not when you over-influence the process, you over-militarize it, everybody can see brazen chaos. No one will accept that. In terms of the other elections that are coming, yes, Ondo is coming. And they will meet that the people of Ondo are just as resolute as the people of Edo. No one should give us the impression that they will cherry-pick elections. The Nigerian people have a couple of things they're thinking about. One of them is that how have their lives been under the APC? You have increased everything. You've increased wealth. You have increased tariff of electricity. You cannot punish the people with poverty and expect to be rewarded with votes. And therefore, what we say is this. Both the APC and the PDP, we should come to election understanding that the interference of political parties and the so-called federal mind has to back off a little bit. And that's why we're commending them. If the military had gone into Edo and gone to aid any of the parties, it would have been obvious. If INEC had circumvented his own plans and processes, it would have been obvious. But when the people cast their vote and the vote of the people count, all Democrats must be happy about it. And in this case, we are happy about it. There's no fluke anywhere. APC has to blame itself for its self-inflicted injury. Everybody who even is not a member of their party, observe the excessive meddlesomeness, the high-handedness of Oshiomhole, aided by no other than the man in Lagos, Ashajibola Tinubu. So there became a narrative in the country that it appeared as if everybody was now going to stand against godfatherism. It was taken to the limit, but the fact remains that it is a reflection of how lowly people who were ordinary Democrats, a comrade of the level of NLC, and its short-trusted Democrats in Bola Tinubu have now begun to look in the mind of the people like the dictators who do not allow democracy to breathe. And Edo people said, get off our neck. It is our state and it is our decision. And they have taken a decision today. It has helped us. We have won. Our party is happy. A fine gentleman in Obaseki has been told to continue the hard work. And whether they like it or not, that is the verdict of history. And history has captured it absolutely very well.
All right. We will still come to the issue of godfatherism, perceived godfatherism, or the real godfatherism, as the case may be. But let me speak now to Mr. Igbokwe. You have heard Mr. Shawumi, in fact, in his words, he said APC has to blame itself for its own self-inflicted injury on itself. What do you say to that?
Okay. We have ruled that state for 12 years. Whether it's AC, SCN, or APC. This is democracy. You know, the funny man you have there is trying to misinterpret what I said about going to hunting expedition. You know, you go and, if you want to go and catch animals in the bush, sometimes you get something, sometimes you don't get. It's a case sometimes you lose. It's not, you don't win all the time. So let somebody not celebrate anything. The only thing that I'm putting on the table this morning is that when PDP wins, democracy is not in danger. Everything is working. God for that reason is not working. We saw all of them trooping to Benin, including Governor Wike. They are not godfathers. You see? So, but when APC wins, democracy will be in danger. We want them to accept it. Elections are coming again. And if we win, they should accept it the way we are accepting it now. That's the spirit of sportsmanship. You know, you always say that when there is a crisis, we maintain our dignity, we hold ourselves. But when the dust settles, we will display ideas that stood us apart. Mm-hmm. We are going to display ideas again. So let them jubilate and celebrate. Let us also, organize ourselves. We are coming back. But when we win, let it not be that democracy is in danger. That's the point I'm making this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Walked away. There are political leaders everywhere. He's talking about God for that reason. There are political leaders everywhere. People must lead. There must be followers. So if you are afraid of somebody and you are jealous of somebody, go and walk and be like him. Go and be like him. I don't want to mention names this morning. He was mentioning names. This godfather. There are godfathers everywhere. There are political godfathers everywhere. There are political leaders everywhere. And they have these are leadership positions they have earned over the years. And they have followers who trust them, who follow them, because they know where they are going, they stand for something, they have an idea, they have been fighting for us for years. So we're not going to just dismiss them with a wave of hand because we are playing dirty politics. That's what I will call it this morning.
I will still stay with you, Mr. Ibokwe. I will still stay with you on this conversation. It is, you mentioned a very crucial point there, which is that after the dust settles, you will go back and discuss the issues that divided you. Now, two names keep popping up as responsible for this loss, which is Oshiomhole and Asiwaju Bola Tinubu. Do you agree to that? Even though you say you're not, going to.
Let me tell you. Let me give you their history. Asiwaju has been the governor of Lagos State. And when Obasanjo stole 5 states in the southwest, he couldn't steal Lagos. And Asiwaju fought back and reclaimed all those things after many years of struggles. So you can understand what I'm saying here. People must stand out and lead. He is a leader and leader. Asiwaju has been in Lagos and he has great followers. He has trained thousands of leaders, including myself that is talking this morning. Okay, let me go back to Oshiomhole. Oshiomhole has been the president of NLC. He has been the governor of Edo State for 8 years. He has been the national chairman of PDP, national chairman of APC. And you think it's a joke? You think that he earned those things overnight? You are now calling him a godfather. If as a national chairman of APC, Nigeria, cannot go back to his state and work and bring APC and place APC into the fold, what are you talking?
All right, let me hear Mr. Shoumi's thoughts on that issue as well. Mr. Shoumi, you're on the other end and also listening into this conversation. What's your reaction to what Mr. Ibokwe has said on the issue of leadership and godfatherism?
The problem with my friend Joe is that he seems to be incapable of hearing what the country and their so-called followers and the Nigerian people are saying. Obviously, no one will argue with the fact that Bola Tinubu was once the governor of Lagos. What the people of Lagos and everybody in Nigeria is saying is that he's kneeling on the knees of the Democrat, where whatever he wishes becomes the law, and whatever he doesn't like must be booted out, no matter how much the people agonize at his decision-making process. As for Oshiomhole, no one will begrudge Oshiomhole for his days in labor. Perhaps people would even commend him a little bit for his days as a new governor. The malady and the melancholy of his situation became extremely difficult for people to tolerate when he collaborated with Ashadi Bola Ahmed Tinubu, became national chairman of their party, and immediately set in motion the loss of that party in a lot of elections because it was a purely recruiting error ab initio. His attitude and conduct was not the type that can keep a party in question. In any case, he has lost Edo now, and he has learned the hard way that no one man represents all of the people, and that all of the people invest a lot of their own capacity to make any one man leader. And the leader cannot be greater than the majority. That said, look, the business of leadership and how it must be wielded in a big party is more around the collegiate system where everybody allows other leaders to chip in. And then the bigger idea on the table is what all of them market to themselves and they run with. The challenge that I see here is that some people over the years have acquired the inordinate desire to always be the one that have it right. And anything that does not follow their expected outcome is considered that must be fought to the brink. They're going to end up imploding their party that way, but I'm beginning to suspect that there are some other younger elements in their party who will not allow such nonsense to take place. Because at the end of the day, for you to have a thriving democracy, you need stable party. Oh, there are no perfect parties. Don't get the impression that I'm saying that one of the parties is perfect and the other is imperfect. No. But we are discussing Edo, and we are discussing what took place in Edo, and we are discussing how the people of Nigeria read it. He needs to go and do an audit of the people, and he will find out that perhaps the reason why that party didn't do well can be singled or maybe pointed finger towards Bola Tinubu of